I recently dropped another gigantic drum and bass Ableton project file. It is called Quantum, and in this video I'm going to be diving into my top D&B tips and tricks for you to use in your own track. And first things first, when it comes to like a melodic track that relies heavily on a lead sound, it's so handy to just stack it. Scratch that. It's so important to just stack it and get that full sound. So this is the lead at the moment, made up of three different layers. But if we just rely on a single lead sound, it's not going to hit the same as if you introduce two more. All different from each other, but still kind of share a similar-ish sound. Honestly, that is key. And then to blend them together, throw them all into the same group, apply some effects, OTT, bit of saturation, and EQ. Reverb before and after the blend them. Just squishes them all together and glues them all together, which is the main thing. If you're already in a habit of layering with your drums, layer with your leads as well, and it'll make a huge difference. And in this project file, I feel like I use a lot of transitionary different techniques and effects to help blend one section into the next. Low pass filters are so simple and easy to use for just like toning the energy down. So for instance, low pass. Restricting high frequencies, the energy is kind of slowly dipping away, but at a very controlled pace. When without it, but with your low pass, you're like signaling to your audience that you're like bringing the energy down, something's about to change. Another cool transitionary trick is to reverb out certain elements. I would recommend higher frequency elements. Reverb out on your bass is going to sound maybe a little bit too muddy. So to explain it, look at this reverb dry wet on this lead. Long decay time, 11 seconds, it's going to ring out for 11 seconds instead of just a dry cut. It's a little bit too abrupt of an ending without just a little bit of reverb. Just have it ring, echo, reverb. It really helps bridge the gap from one high energy intense section to one soft and just mellow section, like this track has. Intense D&B. Slow it right down to the bridge. And the last little transitionary trick is a bass element this time instead of focusing on the leads. So, trap drop mostly focuses around that F note, but if you notice, our chorus starts at B flat. So it's quite a bit of a jump in pitch. So in order to combat that, like I said, we're hovering around that F note, we need to be up at B flat right here. So we just bridge the gap with different notes. So instead of having this, we bridge the gap. We start climbing it up towards the end. So we go to G and then we go to A flat. And then the next logical note in that scale is B flat. So our brain kind of just assumes, oh, we're rising. And this is a really effortlessly trick to just blend two different sections as you're trying to rise to a certain note. So we were trying to rise to that B flat right here at the start, coming from this F. Just a super simple compositional trick there. And since we're around this area in the track, instead of drum and bass drums, halftime drums. So, this is such a classic, been used loads of times. I pull this one from The Tempest by Pendulum. Halftime drums on the last chorus before it gets into the D&B section. You're essentially just slowing down the pace of the kicks and snares. So instead of our normal boom ch, boom ch pattern in drum and bass, we switch it out, we drag the snare across so it's hitting on the third instead of the second and fourth. One beat, two beat, three beat, four beat. Classic metal trick as well, metal artists do this all the time. But yeah, just finding the spot that hits. Different groove, a lot more bouncy, and then builds up, D&B. Definitely worth saving that idea if you're on your final chorus and you're a bit stumped on what to add differently. Halftime drums, build it up, and then go normal pace. Works a treat with drum and bass. And a super easy compositional hack as well. In this track, drop two. Mm-hmm. complete switch up from the normal melodic da 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 da, etc., etc. And that only happens once during the track. However, we're going to use it for our outro as well with a low pass filter. So we're kind of taking this real high intense energy section and using it as the end, but since we're using the low pass filter, we're capping the intense energy of it. So if we just went straight from end of our song to still way too amping, but applying this low pass filter, it's a cool trick to bring the energy right down, just gradually moving it over time. But compositionally or psychologically, it's also familiar in a weird way, so it's not something entirely new for the outro. It's weird because it takes the high energy section and just brings it right down. Low pass filter, once again, underrated as, or perfectly rated. We all know how important low pass filters are. And speaking of energy, using your layers to your advantage. I'm particularly fond of this build up right here because it's so simple, but so effective. Use your existing layers to your advantage. You don't have to create new sections all the time. This is literally, it's just taking our lead and our sub bass from the main chorus, but just pulling in the low pass, and I think on the bass as well. So we're already familiar with the combination of the sub and the lead, but the low pass, high frequencies restricted, just like, we can build up the energy a lot more through that. Yeah, strip it back, lead and bass and just a riser in the background. Anyway, the key point which I was making for that is, you don't have to overcomplicate it, strip back your layers and use some low pass and play with your layers to your advantage. And the last tip is focused on the drums. Try to reference live drums. We're making electronic music here, but we can reference so much from live drums. So for instance, crash on the first downbeat at the start of a new section. Open hat all the time. And then we're getting towards the end of a repetition. Time for a drum fill. It's so simple. And then I'm going into a new section here. Of a few more kicks and snares, it can just be that simple. It doesn't have to be like a massive tom fill. Or if we want to make it super easier and we've got a massive sample library, just load up on some drum fills. It's playing with the sounds that are already there and it's just adding a little bit of variation from like the repetition of boom, ch, boom, ch. I feel like that point is kind of self-explanatory. We all know that. We just need constant reminders of that. So yeah, myself included. And there we have it, drum and bass secret sauce tips number 2. If you did want to pick up this project file, I'll leave a link to it in the description and the comment section. And this project file comes with stems as well, just in case you don't have Ableton. Hopefully you guys learned a thing or two, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace!